Assalamu alaikum once again. We in St. Louis, East St. Louis, dealing with the youth, signing them up so that we can call them up and bring them out to the mosque on Sunday. You know, inshallah, we can get about 300 names. 300 names will assure 110. You know, if we good, if the bait is real, if the sizzle is better than the steak, then they gonna definitely be about 200 strong. But I got some tricks up my sleeve to try to get them there. My thing is to save our people from the sin-sick world that I found myself in. 12 years in the penitentiary. That's absurd. So that's what we're going to do. We're going to help these youngsters out. But you know what? When I'm gone, they're going to have to keep it up. East St. Louis, you got to keep it up. You know, because all I can do is give you a jump start. Call me the jumper cake. I'll start late. I met that brother over there. I didn't know him. I met him in prison. Then I came home in 03. And I ended up making about 1.5 million in 8 months in real estate. And I started taking my money home and started sponsoring and helping them out. And I started, I got 6,000 students that I sponsor now. And you brothers as champions, I want to sponsor dinner for you. Y'all like that?
Yes, sir.
Okay. You see that? Now, you heard them, right? They say, do y'all want me to sponsor dinner?
Yes,
you?
Sir. Yes, sir.
You see? So what I'm going to do is I'm going to get you all to sign up.
In the court. Hey, grab that sheet up. Yeah.
I'm gonna sign all on the coach. I want you to come with us. I'm gonna bring it for you. Please. That's all I need to hear. I sent a bus over here.
My man.
That's what I did. Y'all be right back here.
Yeah,
what time? 10 o'clock? We should be here at 9. We'll be here at 9. Yep. On Sunday.
Morning.
In the morning. Bring it. I want my sponsor them too. Where they at? Say who? Mississippi, you got any clubs? You got any friends? Bring it. And whoever? Now here, this is what I'm going to do for them. Watch this. Listen to this good. Whoever brings the most people, I'm gonna write y'all name down, and whoever brings the most people will get a cash prize. Now, so he bought 3, and he bought 4, he won. And he bought 6, you won. He bought 7. Whoever bought, if you bought 10, and everybody else bought 8, you won. But I'm gonna make sure y'all get something. Just like that. And that's because y'all got a fabulous coach right here who's spending his time with y'all. You know what I'm saying? Many of us don't spend our time like this with the children. We don't do that. So you got it real good here to have a strong brother. He can be doing something else. Y'all hear me? That brother can be doing something else, but he here trying to make y'all better. So when y'all go to the high school over there that won the town, they beat us.
What if we never killed nobody amongst us? No.
We ain't killing nobody. We may have a fight one-on-one.
I had a fight, but I peached them with you fight. Damn, man, y'all all on me. Wait a minute, what's this? There ain't no fair fight. You don't do that.
You know what I'm saying? You don't do that. You ain't get no high marks and $3. You fight my boy, so I stole one. Okay. You see what I'm saying? That's how we get down. I did it too, so I know what it is. You fight my boy, I'm gonna get off. Hey, nigga, how many of y'all gonna jump? All four. Get it, nigga. You know what I'm saying? You see what I'm saying? So everybody goes crazy like this. We ain't known that. I'm down here to encourage change for you so that we can lift you up. Y'all young, man. It look like you know a lot, but you really don't. How do I know? Because I was your age, and I had way more money than y'all at your age. I drove Corvettes and stuff. Brand new. Drop top. Not video.
Come on with
you. Stunt. You see what I'm saying? But I wasn't rapping anymore. Now I'm selling drugs, killing my people, going hard, you know? I had to eat that day, man. But listen, how many of y'all signed that paper? I'm gonna sponsor y'all this weekend. Who didn't sign? Yeah. How y'all been circulating?
Circulating.
Listen. Okay, what did it mean?
Hold on. Hey,
where is it? This is what you do. This is what I do. It's all me up here. Y'all come in. Y'all
come in. Y'all come in. Y'all come in. Y'all come in. Y'all come in. Y'all come in. Y'all come in. Y'all come in. Y'all come in. Y'all come in. Y'all come in. Y'all come in. Y'all come in. Y'all come in. Y'all come in. Y'all come in.
I spoke in 24 schools in 54 days in Chicago. And I'm speaking at this school, but I can say this about this school. Out of all the schools that I've spoken to, none of them are half as beautiful as you. My name is Brother Warren 2X. I am actually the top fisherman in the Nation of Islam in the world, meaning that I bring more people to hear something to stop the killing in our community than anybody else outside of the Honorable Minister Louis Farrakhan. But I also have my company downtown Chicago. I do real estate. I haven't always been an entrepreneur. I haven't always been a real estate entrepreneur, a motivational speaker. And how many of you ever been down with your man? Raise your hand.
Ride
or die. That's good. Ride or die, huh? Ride or die, that's good. Now, I ended up getting 15 years as a youngster, and I ended up going in 1991. I didn't get out until 2003. I just came home 6 years ago. But I was able to establish 40 buildings of my own, Benzes, Hummers, and all of that of my own. I didn't sell any drugs no more. I elevated my mind, I got my spirit together, and I came out here and became consequential. So now I can hire all of y'all. But let me tell you a little bit about You Ride or Die. A couple of my partners had ride or dies, right? How many of y'all got pretty sisters? Now, let Rachel lay your hands down. Now, what happened is, you his woman, you holding the pistol in your purse. The police come up, get down, all of you. He said, I ain't got nothing on me, what's going on? He goes in the car and finds your purse. But you holding it for your man. Your man said, that ain't in my purse. She said, who purse is it? She said, it ain't mine. He goes in, looks at your wallet, it's your ID, your pistol. You look at your man and say, boo,
Boom. And you go to jail, and now you in there blowing his phone up, he ain't answering the phone. Your girlfriend is coming to visit you, and she got some news for you. Your man is messing with your sister, girl, and they be in the car, and she talking about she gonna marry him, and you doing all this time in prison for him. You see, you ride or die, they gonna rat and snitch on you. They're gonna tell on you. You see what I'm saying? So you gotta be real careful. Like the brother said, the thugs and the gangsters, the one y'all like, you like me? Yeah, nigga, rat. Yeah, nigga.
She did it!
They're gonna tell on you. You're gonna go to prison. Now, let me tell you what happens in prison. See, y'all cheating. Y'all don't, please don't go to prison, them girls. See, when you go to prison, you could get killed. And you don't know nobody in there. Many people been in prison. Like when I was in prison, I didn't know nobody. I came in there walking. I had long braids. So I was done. I was stunned. First of all, you got gay people in there that wasn't gay. They didn't. You know how you gay. Some people get gay, and that's your decision. Okay, but in there you don't have no decision. You come in there, you straight. You come out gay. How did you come in straight and go out gay? Because I couldn't fight, and the dude punched me in my stomach, and I told him, take whatever you want. You see, this is what's happening. But why do you even have to go to jail? See, I went to jail. I was a Golden Glove fighter. When I was a youngster, that helped me in prison. They wasn't even trying to fight me. I was starting to fight. You know, when you're young, you in there playing dominoes. You call them bees and hoes when you play dominoes. I'm playing dominoes, but I think, you know, the youngs slapping dominoes. Yeah, B. You see, I'm crazy in there, you know. And then a brother who's been there 5-10 years, he say, brother, please, brother, don't call me the B. I ain't no B. I look up at him. Oh, okay, man. Bitch ass. You see, so now I'm going at him like this. But I'm thinking it's just, you know how we do that, y'all.
Hey, B, what's up, B? Come on, B, you late, B.
But it's natural for you to say that. But when someone else coming to you and holler, you can whisper it to them. What you say? What was that? Look at me. You see what I'm saying? But your girlfriend been calling your bees all day. And I just whispered it. I wasn't even trying to let you hear it. But you heard it. And now you got a problem with me. You see how messed up our minds are? But we got to get our minds together. You see what I'm saying? You got to get it together. They come in there, dudes run up on me, you call me a B, man. I said, man, I was playing games. Nigga, bitch. You know, but I'm just playing. He said, oh, nigga, you ain't playing. He came out with a knife. I said, what's that? What you finna do that? You got some water on the side? I want a slice. So now, he chasing me with the knife. When he chasing me with the knife, I break out of mine. I said, I'm a trench star, you fool. You can stab me. I run out of there, but I'm learning lessons. I'd have fights in there, beat them down. If they can't fight, they just beat. But you don't need to go in there. It's different when you are good Muslim girl. I, my boyfriend, he was a gangbanger. I didn't know. A suffer law. No. Your boyfriend, he's a terrorist. No, he's a Negro. So now you got this guy got you in trouble. Cause you with him, now you in trouble. Supposed to have been virtuous, but he didn't trick me. I love you. Okay. You see what I'm saying? I love man. Yeah. Yeah, yeah, you're gonna be you. But the thing is, as long as he's not gang banging and doing this, I don't think that you should have a boyfriend right now. I think that you should be focused on your education so that you can get something done. Like, take it from me. When I got out of prison, believe me, I hadn't had a girl in 12 years. And I was a spokesman in prison. No girls. And I thought I was gonna be virtuous. I'm straight. I'm a Muslim. Muslims don't do nothing to marry. This girl was like, okay. You need some fruit, some money? Yeah, I could take a few dollars. I'm broke. They took my $1.5 million. I ain't got no money. Sure, I take it. But the women start acting real nice to me. Yeah, you look tense. You need a massage? Yeah, I'll take a massage. What is this? You see, they wooed me to death. Next thing you know, I have a girlfriend now. How did that happen? Just like it happened to me, it can happen to you all. And now I'm going through some stress. Now I'm stressed out. I'm getting text messages, you bastard. Damn, what happened with this? What I do? Check back what I do. I saw you with that bee. Same thing that you go through. But why do we have this stress? I wipe the stress off, you know, but you gotta break up, make up, and then if you start having sex, now you got a Jones. You just like a crackhead. You know how a crackhead need that crack? And the sex fiend need that sex? It happens. Now, I ain't being nothing. I ain't in line. You know, it happens. You know, if people getting pregnant, you pregnant now, how you gonna babies having babies? What's wrong with us? Now I'm saying this, if you have the baby's here, we love the baby, everybody's gonna take care of the baby. Well, if you see that, then why would you even take that same course? Well, he cute, he got braids. He a leader of the GDs. He got a spot. You see what I'm saying? You don't need that in your life right now. Take it from me, because what's gonna end up happening is somebody gonna do something right. Somebody gonna get shot and killed. And if you're there, you're gonna be accessory to murder. You see what I'm saying? And now you in prison. And you come out looking harder than me. You know what I'm saying? And then, how many of y'all can dance? Let me tell you what happened in prison with dancers. When I went to prison, the girls were in prison right across from us. Every girl that can dance good, you get all the attention from all the butch girls. Ooh, she dancing. Ooh, my God, she dropping like it's hot. Damn, ooh, look at her. She bobs that bag. You see what I'm saying? So you go in there thinking, hey, that's my song. And you just dancing because it's your song. And all these girls looking at you. Next thing you know, either you get beat up, get took, get messed up, come out of here, don't nobody want you because you didn't look like a man. You've been looking like a man for about 2 years. Now all of a sudden you look like a man naturally. What's up? Damn, what's wrong with your face? What's wrong with your face? I got a picture of you. Look at you now. You know, in CBS High School, they got the highest level of HIV. They all your side. Roosevelt? Okay. How you know? You the statistic? You the doctor? You test everybody? You see, if you ain't test everybody, you don't know. I'm not saying that you got it or you don't, but I'm saying that don't be having intercourse without condoms. I can't say, I would tell you don't have it at all. But I'm saying this. Yeah, you clap for that. Don't have it at all. The only reason, listen to this. The only reason y'all have sex is because a guy come up to you and be like, damn, you thick. On my sheep, you all that. You like skin too. Big. Look at your hair. Damn, I like those big earrings. Head on hand too. Jazz. Ooh, she got purple hair. Man, she's colored up. Ooh, black. you a favor. Then, all of a sudden, you may not like him, but now all of a sudden, you his friend. Hey, what's up?
Hey, what's up, Mike? Come over here, Mike, come over here.
And next thing, y'all at the show and everybody together, but ain't nobody with nobody. And all of a sudden, y'all wrestling. You know how we wrestle? Guys, he's wrestling how we wrestle, like this. Listen, so you know how you slap and y'all fight? You know how guys and girls do that? Then all of a sudden, that's a form of, like, what you call that? It's like courting a little bit. It's like foreplay. Don't grab me from the back. Come here, girl, pick you all up.
Stop, please, stop.
You know, you see what I'm saying? That's what you do. Now he all rubbing all up on you.
Ooh, what's that? You nasty.
No, that was my wallet. You see, you can't do that. Because now you go home, girl, you know what he did? He gonna pick me up. His stuff was hard. No, it wasn't, girl. He loved you. You see what I'm saying? And now all of a sudden, a week, 2 weeks later, oh, y'all, you see them together all the time. They walk together. Why y'all together? Who is that? Man, let me hug her. Don't touch my girl. Damn. Your girl. What's happening around here? Your girl. This your man?
It's my boo.
And next thing you know, y'all doing whatever y'all do. But you gotta protect yourself. The most valuable asset you got right now is not what's between your legs, but it's what's between your ears. And if you exercise what's between your ears, then I'll see you in 5-6 years and you have your degrees and everything.
Hey, you was at the school, remember? I didn't let them niggas get nothing. They be trying to.
See, you would have had all of that. But some of y'all, you see, hey, you were begging on both.
Hey, I have twins.
Well, what school you was at?
Roosevelt, you know?
What's that? What's y'all? Your mascot? I'm telling y'all what it's gonna be. But you have to be, don't be no rough riding now. Don't get crazy. I'm just playing with you. You know, I'm just trying to have some humor with this. It's a real ugly point, but sometimes you gotta feed them that hard teaching with some humor. Because there's nothing funny about going to jail. There's nothing funny about getting stabbed or shot. There's nothing funny about catching AIDS. Catching an STD, I don't care if it just crabs.
Lord, today!
Why is you itching all the time, girl? You dirty. Oh, this nigga dirty. You see, you gotta be careful. Protect yourself. And hey, y'all keep signing up this paper. I'm giving you the best that I can give you right now. And I want you all to be successful. I want you to sign up because we're going to have something. I might sponsor something for you. Would y'all like that?
Yeah!
Okay. How about this weekend do something real big?
Down the phone hookup, trying to raise the dead to hear brother Warren 2X deliver this powerful message tomorrow. Right there we have our brother Captain Abel right there doing his homework as always. Right here we have brother Paul Muhammad, Mr. Important Brother, doing his work. Yes sir. Right here we have Brother Secretary, Brother Earl, the most business man in the Mars right here, doing his footage, doing his work.
Yes,
right here we have Brother Ishmael, doing his work, resurrecting the dead as always. Right here we have our big brother, Brother Kamola Muhammad. Doing his work as always, resurrecting the dead.
At 8:30, we're going to see y'all guys there at 8:30 tomorrow morning. We'll have
as you see, Muhammad Mob 28B is very busy in doing the work of the most honorable Elijah Muhammad. Brother Warren 2S, the number one fisherman in the Nation of Islam. He and Mob 28B representing, doing the work of the most honorable Elijah Muhammad is always and resurrecting the dead so we can pack the Mob tomorrow morning. Brother Warren 2X.
Yeah, you see Brother 1-2-X from Chicago down here, East Boogie. You know how we get down in Chicago. Y'all know me. They say the prophet is always rejected, always despised, pushed back in his own hometown. But when he goes out abroad, he was well received and well compensated for what he does. I love these brothers out here in the city. I'm going all over the world, and I'm going to train and teach the black man how to raise the dead so that our brother and minister, Honorable Minister Louis Farrakhan, will be happy, not just for my work, but for all of our work, because it's not good for a solo. We need to quiet.
That's right.
We need to relax.
Yes, sir.
Oh, yeah, by the way, Ramadan Mubarak.
Yes, sir. Ramadan Mubarak.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, you just heard it from the number one fisherman in the Nation of Islam, Brother Warren 2X, being busy as always, calling around to resurrect the dead, bringing in here the most honorable Elijah Muhammad, and his number one guy on the scene right now, the Minister Louis Farrakhan. Just heard it from his mouth, number one fisherman, Brother Warren 2X.
You see them poor buckets out here in a strange land, not my own. Yeah, they empty now. If it be the will of Allah, all four of them will be filled in no time. Yeah, do this. Yeah, we represent at Mars 28B. Y'all see it? Start the chilling now. You see the rest of them.
Be scared of this camera. That's the man right there. They waiting on you, brother. They waiting on you, brother.
Well, tell them I'm waiting on them too.
Brother Minister in the house.
Yeah. So we need somebody today that's not scared to talk to our people.
Come on.
We need somebody today that's not scared to tell our people that hurting each other is wrong. We need somebody that's not scared today to start teaching our people and to help each other. Now let me tell you something. Knowledge is a vital right that identifies the nature of God. And we need only the wisdom of God right now.
Hey, he's changing. Better man, so I can come out here and not sell no more dope. and I had 20 girlfriends again. Again. But I'm glad that you made me the man that I am, and I know the Honorable Miss Lewis Farrakhan is going to see this, and I thank you for everything that you've done for me thus far. Assalamu alaikum. It's Dub 10 in the house.
Each man over you, and you're gonna get their name,
and I'm gonna get all the product that we possibly can, and we're gonna make salesmen out of all of you so that you can start operating and start making money right here in your own town. How would you like that? Many of you know, that's why I understand y'all very well. The sisters, y'all gangbang too.
I'm cheap.
I had a situation. I was going to this young guy's, he was going to college, or going to prom or something. And the little girls took one girl's phone, it was her sister or something. She said, I'm cheap, I'ma bust your head. I'm cheap. So I already know who cheap is, but I locked up with him. So I stopped the little girl. I said, let me come here for a minute. She's about 12 years old. She said, let me tell you something. I said, you said on chief when she took your phone. I heard that. I just wanted to know who chief. Who is that? Jesus. She said, no. I said, do you know who the person is? She said, no. Chief. I said, I bet you I can tell you who it is and where you got it from. I said, you want me to tell you? And you tell me if I'm right. She said, go ahead, tell me. I said, you have a little boyfriend over here, and they little GDs, and they don't cheat. Don't cheat it up some better than them niggas. And you heard them saying that, and he's cute to you, and that's your little boyfriend, and every time he get over there, he do the folks, throw the folks up, and you looking at him doing it. And you hear him say,
what's going on, man? Ain't nothing, I'm cheap, we're gonna go whoop them niggas.
And you listen at him, you listen, and now you run with your girlfriend.
I'm cheap.
And the little girl said, yeah, that's exactly. Baby, and then G. I said, GD's over here. Yeah, that's Carlos over here. This is how the most song about Muhammad said, a nation can rise no higher than this woman. You see, and if we teach them this negative energy, then we really ruin our children in them, because the woman is the first rearer of the child. Right. So if she thinking on cheap and the baby get up, you gonna see your baby at 2 years old, bad as hell. Man, what's wrong with you, man? Go over there, why he so bad? I'm never here. Who made him bad? Well, you made him bad, because you trained her to do the fool, and then she trained him to be a fool. Now I go to penitentiary. When I go in the penitentiary, my mama call me in the penitentiary and tell me, your daddy's on his way up in there. You see? So when we go to penitentiary, you go find your son. So I'm in there with my dad. I said, it's not right, man. You in the penitentiary with me, man? You a little older, man, but I'm a goon up in here, man. I gotta protect you. I'm locked up with my father, man. We gotta discourage that. That's why I came out of prison, so I can discourage you all from doing this. We got the East Side, East Boogie, and St. Louis. And it ain't no drama. It's no drama up in here. Don't it normally be drama? East Boogie don't like St. Louis. St. Louis call them river rats. Under Islam right now. Islam quells all of that. I'm a ex-Black Peacestone. L. Rookie, Jeff Ford, Chief Malik. Them my guys. Hoover and all them. Hoover and Jeff Ford is friends. They in ADX. You know what ADX is? ADX is when you locked up 23 hours a day in one room for hundreds of years. You see what I'm saying? Locked up in here, Hoover in this room, Chief Malik in this room. Every day they get grayer and grayer and older, and they talk through the room. Hey, what's going on, Chief? Amen. You heard anything from the folks? Nah. They don't even listen to me no more. What the governor said? They all in the field. They left him. What about the moles? Man, they went crazy. Where the people over there? They gone. They locked up too. Where the structure at? It's every man for himself now. And now they smart. You know what they be saying in there? Chief Malik and Hoover? I wish I never did that. I can't never get out of here again in my life. My son on his way to jail now. He got 4 years. Chief Malik's son was locked up with me. He came out 6 months. He got killed by some old black stones. Face down in the river in Indiana. I told him don't go out there with that madness. The other son, Wakita, he in jail. For the brothers who most, you know Wakita from Motown. He in jail for 40 years. What we gonna do? We going to jail too? And most of the brothers is dead. They locked up and dead. The girls with you, the moles, they in jail too. They got caught up in a conspiracy. How do I know? Because the men are in jail over here. It's a gate right here. And the sisters are over there. And sometimes we can come over there and wish we can get with them and talk crazy to them. Girl, you sure getting thick over there. You thick too. Yeah, you know? And we talk like, can you imagine that, man? For 12 years, I didn't have no woman, man. Y'all can't go 12 hours. Oh, Chief, I gotta get out of here. I'm coming, boo. I'm coming. Y'all know, because I was your age, I'm just like that. And you too. Y'all ain't no exception to the rules. Y'all know, that's why y'all screaming about me. I'm scared of y'all. Y'all thirsty. But the main thing is, you're more valuable than what's between your legs. What's between your ears is far more valuable. Give yourself a round of applause for that. See, the thing is, I listen to a lot of preachers, right? They be preaching, preach. I'm like, preachers, man. They just preach me on out of here. But I'm not nobody's preacher, man. I'm not no preacher. I'm not preaching, y'all. We talking. And I got your undivided attention, and that's the way I like it. Because when it comes time for you to unite with me, how many of y'all want to unite with me to make this happen in the nation? Raise your hand. No, stand up all you want to unite with me, and we can make something happen. Stand up. Let me see. It don't take that long. It don't take all day. You see what I'm saying? We don't need to be talking all day. We need to be ending and setting up situations so that you can sit down. Everybody can sit down. It don't take all day. Now let me say this to you. In closing, because what we're gonna do, we're gonna be late for time. What we're gonna do, we're gonna get 20 people. On one list, 20 people on one list as all the women, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20. And what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna cherry pick people that's gonna call you, and I'm gonna facilitate to them jobs for you all, because we already got a structure. It's already rolled out. I could deal with 1,000 people right now, and this ain't but about 400 at the most. We could deal with about 1,000. But you have to be effective, and you have to be trained. How many of you are willing to go through a 30-day training session? All right. I got my guy. Gotcha. On my life. Hey. Now, here's the next question. The thing is, how many of you have transportation to get to your destination when you have to be there? Y'all got bus passes, right? Okay. All right. Now, you have to come like, y'all listening? Listen up. You all have to come like twice a week for 30 days. Can y'all do that? Okay. MGT, y'all classes that's on Saturdays, right? Yeah, they won't be able to be on a Saturday with them. FOI, when is the processing class? Monday night. Well, y'all, the guys will come on a Monday. That's one day. And then we'll create another day. And in 30 days, everybody working. Everybody. We got to make that happen. We will make that happen. You know, if we have to, listen to this. Where did Marlo at? If we have to put 10,000 up a piece, that's to invest in the product that we need and we know that the people need for them to start. That's what we got to do.
Yes, sir.
You understand? That's what we got to do. Because if we don't take, listen to me, if we don't take care of you all, who will? Who gonna take care of y'all? Suburbs, they got people taking care of theirs, right? Way out, not in the hood, they took care of. But those in the hood, whether you're black or white, we gonna take care of you. Cause that's just the way we are. You see what I'm saying? That's just the way it is with us. We don't care if you black or white, you got your back. You got your back. Just like that. Now, since I said that, you'll see the brother dating white girl.
You see him. You see him all together.
We're gonna leave us. But that's okay. It's all right. Something, yes, I don't even know, but I know it was over 400. We had 6 buses and unlimited cars. I just thank Allah for the blessing. We played four quarters. Thursday, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. Those are the 4 quarters that I need in any city, any state. And I can make something happen. As long as I'm obedient to the restricted laws, I'm be okay. It's my victory. I got a victory. I ain't broke no laws. Kept myself chased. Praise be to Allah. I'm gone. It's for you, brother. I don't miss Lewis Farrakhan. It's all for you, man. You deserve it. You fought hard for us for 50 plus years. You need to see some shining results for your name. I'm just one of the sparks that's showing you that we get consequential when we drink from and suck from your table. One of them. All praise be to Allah. I believe you got a whole lot more. Brother Nuri, you know. A few more. Brother Burby, you got some. We're going to have thousands of them in a minute.
Plenty more.
Let it unfold. Praise be to Allah. Peace and all day.